amount of wealth found. From the latest expeditions to the underground, the miners of the frontier have brought up riches unimaginable. Object, identified or otherwise, the Nepalk is the best defense technology the elves can offer.
large cave system and followed all sorts of bizarre, complex chambers that appeared to have no end. Then we went through this little opening and we started going down and down and down and further into this long tunnel. All of a sudden it opened into this beautiful, huge cavern, and a lake that went further into the cavern. There were all kinds of rocks and crystals and stone walls. Then we dug ourselves into this side chamber of these things that looked like a massive tuning fork. It looks like we found some sort of ancient gold mining operation with some weird tools and artifacts still in it. Some sort of unidentified technology mate. They seem like new sophisticated equipment, but apparently they're really old and we haven't figured out how to use most of them. One of them seemed to emit some sort of peculiar beam, and I held one like some sort of speaker. It had these little symbols or notches on the end with a golden inscription that looked like some sort of geometric particle symbol. They seem like practical tools. I'll study up on them a bit more and keep you updated. Yes, they were the part of the tower of sound, water, natural forces. All of this technology is clearly recorded in history. Natural forces are harnessed even in these memories. You can see hardly much of the records. They're perfectly shaped granite and diorite, and these perfectly fit the stone walls. You could have shaped these kinds of hard stones in different ways without some sort of advanced method. They may be extremely hard into modern minerals. These igneous rocks will wear down normal old tools. Modern technology, it would take diamond tip tools and lots of cooling fluid to achieve this kind of stonemasonry. This discovery will change our perception of history and probably find an explanation to our mysteries of the past. So we've been working now studying this large apparatus which I mentioned before. It looks like a huge tuning fork and it seems to be some sort of sonic drill. Some sort of frequency gauge going on in the back, and if the resonant frequency of the cutting rod could somehow match the frequency of the fork was attached to, it could work as a giant drill. Traverse vibrations from the fork prongs and move the bottom of the U-shape up and down, which sends longitudinal waves at the rod's resonant frequency. These vibrations create standing waves with a maximum vibration at the beginning and the end of the rod. There's a point of no vibration in the middle where some sort of operating system is attached. We are trying now here to get them to resonate to a specific frequency without hitting with a hammer. If this doesn't bear fruit, I guess we'll have to get more people here to analyze the operating systems in the middle. I'll talk to you later. more information. So you can talk to this archaeologist, which is as soon as she comes back to the Tavern of the Surface, she'll tell you more. But what we've already been hearing from the intercoms, the scroll she's translating, and the information you're about to hear is something you're going to want to take a seat for. Translating tablets are talking about some ancient inner Earth civilization who created our species down there. Understanding of ourselves and our history will be substantially rewritten, mate. Exciting, but it makes my head spin.